It's the NFL on EA Sports. And if it's in the game, it's in the game. It's the New York Giants and the New York Jets. And it's all just ahead on Madden NFL 24.
On a warm late summer afternoon, EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Straight ahead, we've got a pretty good one on tap here, as it'll be the New York Giants and their inner city rivals, the New York Jets. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. Well, it's always fun when we get these two New York teams together, but this year feels a little different. You know, these fan bases always a little fickle to say the least, but I would say optimism in both fan bases as we begin 2023.
And justified optimism, because you go back to last season, the Giants proved it on the field, got back to the playoffs, and they feel like they're only going to get better. As for the Jets, their optimism is because Aaron Rodgers is in town. That and a strong defense, they believe, will get them into contention in the AFC East.
And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. The new-look Jets ready to go on offense, and it is the veteran Aaron Rodgers at quarterback.
After years of flirting with the idea, the four-time MVP finally found his way out of Green Bay this offseason, guiding himself to the Jets. We know he's already a Hall of Fame lock, but this is a chance to add one more crowning achievement to his resume.
Oh, did the Jets miss this guy? Here's Breece Hall. And this will be a gain of five as he gets it to the 30.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there, because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
On first and 10, it's Hall. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
They suspected it was a power play up the middle coming at them, and boy, were they right. That defense got downhill in a hurry and limited them to just a couple on first down.
On play action, Rodgers. It's caught inside the 25 and down to the 16-yard line. Big yardage that time for the Jets. 43 yards.
Brandon, we've both been around the game long enough that we know that in pregame, defenses are pretty amped up, aren't they? I mean, they're pounding lockers, and they can't wait to get out there. But when you hit them with some big pass plays early, it takes the starch right out of them.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Straight ahead is Hall. And able to surge forward for about 5 yards down to the 10.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Ball sits on the 10, second and 5. Now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon. Big Dwayne Brown, the tackle, guilty there. A false start penalty, and now they're back to needing 10 yards on second down. Now it's Rodgers. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Well, hang on a second here, because on that last play, it appears one of the Giants shaken up. We'll get an update when we return to MetLife Stadium. The seventh play now of this opening drive. This is third and long, though. Throwing is Rodgers. Got a man, it's caught. Touchdown, Jets. Aaron Rodgers hitting Alan Lazard. And the Jets get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon.
Well, that's what I call an answer right there. They gave up a sack on the previous play. How about what they did to finish things off, turning it right back around?
That's the response, and that O-line feels a lot better now, don't they?
Yeah, without a doubt, because give up the sack in the previous play, that just hurts those guys because they never want to see their guy get hit.
Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. He's got it, and the Jets lead 7-0. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told, and it ends with a Jet touchdown. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback.
The Giants ready to go now on offense, and under center is the man in possession of a new contract for 2023 and beyond. In his fifth season now, Daniel Jones.
Playing for his Giants career, Jones's best season as a starter didn't come with huge numbers as a passer. He was just the guy his team needed him to be, someone who could threaten the defense throwing it, and especially as a runner.
Throwing Jones. And that'll be off the mark, too far out in front, and it's incomplete.
As defensive coordinators around the league tell me all the time, that throw is not for every quarterback because you've really got to drive the ball downfield. It's going to be a tight window for him to fit that one into. In this case, unsuccessfully.
Blitz coming and down he goes. The former third overall pick, Quinnen Williams, there to bring him down.
All right, partner, I'm going to be Captain Obvious right here. Not the start you're looking for offensively, right? Incomplete pass, followed by a sack.
And when he went down, it looked like that right ankle got turned, but thankfully he popped up okay, and they breathed a sigh of relief on that sideline. After that sack, third and long, tough spot for Jones and the Giants. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. That's complete to his tight end, Waller. 5 yards, and that means they come up short, as they're going to have to punt here on the opening drive. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Giant football, and we're ready to begin the second quarter. On fourth down, here's Jamie Gillen on to punt. Here's Hardman to return. We call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And the Jets will take over first and 10. Back onto the field come the New York Jets for their second drive.
This could end up being a pretty big drive. I mean, look, yes, it's early in this game, but they scored the touchdown. They got the stop. And now if they could get in the end zone here again, CD, they could grab an early stranglehold on this one.
Yeah, they certainly can. And that's what you're looking for. Where's the advantage? Can you gain it? Can you press it? Now for them, finishing it off, because right now it's out there for them. They've just got to go seize it.
Dexter Lawrence finding his way through defensively for the stop.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave him 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Give him 7 there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third. They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. From the gun on third down, Rodgers. They're able to complete this one to Tyler Conklin. He's going to pick up the first down and end zone. And down to the 27-yard line. A gain of 22.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Paul on a give up the middle. And only a yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26.
2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. So from the 26-yard line, here's the 2nd and 9. Rodgers now to throw. Open there, here is Conklin. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And that's going to make it 3rd down and less than a yard.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on 2nd down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives him a much better opportunity to convert on 3rd down.
They'll run with Hall. And he's able to pick up the 1st down before he's tackled right at the 10. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
Throwing on 1st down is Rodgers. And he's going to go down, sacked back at the 13-yard line. Dexter Lawrence able to bust free and get to the quarterback.
Well, there's still time to rectify this situation because the silver lining, they took a sack on 1st and goal. But that close to the goal line, that still definitely hurts.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Those are the ones you dream of as defenders. I think if he gets eyes on the ball a little bit earlier, he might come away with it. Instead, it's going to wind up as just an incomplete pass.
Rodgers now on 3rd and goal. Hard throw, incomplete. Credit the Giants defense that time in pass coverage. 4th down.
They converted twice on 3rd down that drive already, but couldn't make it a 3rd. We always talk about in-game adjustments. How about what the defense did there, able to shut them down on that attempt?
Zerline's kick is up and through. So another scoring drive there, Charles, and an early 2-score lead.
You'd like the 6 there, partner, but you'll take the 3, and I think they have to be happy about the way they moved the ball in these first 2 drives. They have to feel good about their opportunities the rest of the game.
Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. The Giants now going to take over late in this 1st half. And with him down 2 scores, you wonder if they might try and put something together, even if it's just to get into field goal range. Now Jones. They'll set up the screen to Barkley. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
Nice job by the defense figuring that play out and holding it to a short game. But I don't think the offense is going to be daunted. They actually accomplished their goal there. Now they've got them aware that they can throw a screen at them, maybe to slow the pass rush down a little bit, and they can throw it downfield.
It's Barkley once again bringing in the catch. So we've hit halftime here at MetLife Stadium with the home team, the Jets, leading this one. As we get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everyone, to our brand-new studios here in downtown Orlando in the EA Sports Halftime Report. This has certainly been a fun one to watch so far. We knew this was going to be a battle, and we have not been disappointed. This is the kind of game that could wind up hinging on which side can play mistake-free football the rest of the way.
All right, Coach, thank you very much as we welcome you back for quarter number 3. 10-0 is our score as we get started again on EA Sports. No run back here to begin the half, and we will start at the 25-yard line. Here's the Giants offense now getting set to start the 3rd quarter. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter 3.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well, and they've kept them around in this game. Now, they've got some time, The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
Well, when the running game's not working, sometimes you just got to take a few more chances down the field. That's a good effort, but it winds up incomplete.
Jones from the gun on third down. Got an open man. That's Campbell. And he will have a Giants first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, that's the kind of play that was lacking all the way through the first half. Maybe this can give them a little bit of a spark because they're not out of this game by any stretch.
Jones now on first down. And oh, that nearly their first pick of the game, but it falls down to the ground incomplete. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Jones fakes the give to Barkley. He'll be taken down. The Jets get in there for the sack. Quinnen Williams able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
I'd say it's not panic time yet, but let's be honest about it. Empty possession here, not what you're looking for when you're down a couple of scores.
Absolutely not. Trying to start the second half off on the right foot. Unfortunately, going to give the ball up. After that sack, third and long, tough spot for Jones and the Giants. Throwing on third and long, Jones. Short throw, going to be caught by Waller. Call it a gain of a yard, and it'll be fourth down. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, and people have to come up with schemes to limit him, and what a lot of teams do, they'll double him, you know, use a linebacker underneath, a safety over the top. Sometimes they'll just take a corner, maybe their third corner if he's a bigger guy, and put him on a man-to-man to try and limit his touches. Just keep mixing it up, give him different angles, different looks, like a good boxer does.
Hardman on the return. 8 yards on the return following a punt of 41. And the Jets will take over. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. Rodgers and the Jets now with a first and 10 at their own 22. He'll give it to Hall to start the drive. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
They'll get 13 yards for the second play in a row.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game. On first down, Rodgers. He'll find Lazard here over the middle. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46. Three quarters in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here at MetLife Stadium. It's Jet football as they've got the lead here, and we get set to begin quarter number 4. From the 46, here's the 2nd and 4. On 2nd down, a run with Hall. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. 52 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front 7, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing. Slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
On 1st and 10, here's Rodgers. And this is caught inside the 5. 36 yards on the play.
And this is seemingly how it's been all game long. This defense has been just a step too slow. And here they're burned again. Another big play.
A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And this will be caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Randall Cobb from a yard out. And the Jets are an extra point away from making this a three-score game. Well, that's just how they drew it up, CD. His first read was there, got it to him quickly, and into the end zone.
Absolutely excellent execution by all involved. And the coordinator, got to give him credit, found the perfect play call. Quarterback let it fly as soon as the target came free, and his guy made a nice catch. Just how you draw it up in practice and then execute it in the game.
Zuerlein good with a PAT. And that makes our score 17-0. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. And New York set to take the field.
Well, it's been a struggle so far for this offense, Charles. It's not only that they haven't been able to put the points up, but really stringing yards together has been a real issue for them in this one.
I'm so glad you brought up the yardage, because I was thinking to myself, we've seen a lot of NFL games, and we've seen our share of lopsided contests, but in almost all of them, both offenses have put up at least 200 yards in a game, but not in this one. This has been a display of offense that, frankly, I think the two of us have watched from behind our hands, trying to spread our fingers wide enough to actually see the result.
And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32, and they're going to hurry back to the line now. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
Oh, I thought he had that one, and that was nearly a big third down conversion to give this drive some life. Instead, they're on the spot and help separate the receiver from the ball.
Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. The Giants go on fourth, but come up empty. And the Jets are going to get the football here in great field position. Well, at this stage of the game in the second half, down 3 scores, I guess they felt like they needed to push.
And let's face it, with this deficit, if they give up another score here after they didn't get it, does it really matter?
Right.
It really doesn't. They had to go and try and make something happen if they had any chance of winning this game.
And just good downhill running there as he'll take this to the 15-yard line.
17 yards for the Jets there as they've got themselves a first down. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10.
Up the middle they go. Knight, and he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. Good gain there on first down. It keeps them in a running situation, probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front. Good blocking. Nice hole for him. Ends up picking up nice yardage. Stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They are in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay that way.
And not in any rush offensively. A handoff for Hall. And he's going to be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down.
Early down stuff's to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
5 in the secondary now for the Giants here on third. Throwing now is Rodgers. And it's caught. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence, and that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal. They'll run with Hall. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. So it's a victory here for the New York Jets. And they did it in shutout fashion. Impressive.
Would it be too bland of a statement to say they didn't have the greatest day offensively?
Did enough, though. But yeah, you're right.
Most games, it wouldn't have been enough. So they've got to go into the locker room and applaud their defensive mates and say, guys, you really carried us today. We'll try and get you back next time. But as for today, you guys were nails out there.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at EASports.com.